A year after serving as the team's hybrid fullback, Chris Obanaya finds himself down on the depth chart at both fullback and running back this season. He's going to need to rely on his versatility to keep a spot on the team.
Each year that when you start a new season, you have to reinvent yourself. So last year was more of a fullback role, and it allowed me to grow within the offense and do a lot of different things. But it's always been a thing that's very important to me. I take a lot of pride in what I do, to be able to wear a lot of different hats. And so whatever they ask me to do, that's what I'm going to do.
You feel confident that you'll be here? I mean, when you look at the depth chart, you feel like you're going to find a play. You're going to make them find a place for you on his roster?
I don't worry about that stuff. I think that I've played long enough to understand anything can happen. But at the same time, I have to come to work each day with that mentality that I'm the starter at whatever position that might be and do my best job.
Obanaya is facing uncertain times both on and off the field. He is of Nigerian descent, and he's very concerned about his relatives in the West African Republic, which has been plagued by Islamic insurgency and also an outbreak of Ebola.
Most of my dad's siblings still live there, the ones that are still alive, but most of them live there. And I haven't been there in a long time, over 10 years since I've traveled to Nigeria. So it's an unfortunate situation, but hopefully things work out for the best.
To see what's going on there now and then the Ebola thing that's going on, how tough is it to see, you know, your homeland or your family's homeland?
It's definitely tough, I think. Being born in the States and growing up here and the accessibility we have to healthcare definitely makes a huge difference. I think that something like that comes over here, we have the resources to contain it a little bit easier as opposed to being in a third world country that they have those issues. And so hopefully they can contain it, do a better job. A lot of people have already been affected by it or killed by the disease. And so hopefully it's something that they can control and get a better grasp of. And it's crazy. It's a tough situation. I think during the World Cup, there are a lot of bombings, a lot of radical movements there, and it's an unfortunate situation.
So what your dad's people are going through, does it kind of put up in the perspective what your, you know, football and a lot different than what's going on in that homeland?
I think it's anything. I think that natural disasters, disease, losing somebody, anything can put things in perspective. And you understand what we do is our job, but at the same time, it's a game. And we're very fortunate to be able to do this, to play a game that a lot of fans support us and a city is behind us. So I always remember that in the back of my head, and it's a privilege to play. It's not a right. So if you have that type of appreciation, you understand other things better.